During startup, a flow path is established to the atmosphere through valves called startup vent valves, or sky vents. The sky vents can be installed on LP, IP, hot reheat, or high-pressure superheater outlet piping. The valves are typically equipped with an upstream isolation valve, usually motor-operated. Sky vent logic is programmed to observe the temperature change in the associated steam drum and limit the rate of change anywhere from 3.5 degrees Fahrenheit per minute in high-pressure steam to 50 degrees Fahrenheit per minute in the IP and LP steam drums. At startup, when pressure in the associated steam drum starts to build and the vent valve starts to open, the upstream isolation block valve will open. The control system logic will calculate the saturation temperature of the steam drum based on the sensed pressure. This is the temperature that is used to control the sky vent valve. The sky vent will open as the temperature starts to rise. If the temperature change rises above the set point, the sky vent will continue to open to reduce the pressure rise. The sky vent will open or close to maintain the temperature rise in the steam drum at its set point. Once pressure rises enough that the steam header bypass valves are in service, steam drum temperature and pressure changes are subtle, allowing the sky vents to start closing slowly and redirect the steam being vented downstream to the bypass valves. When the sky vent system operates, it has a high differential pressure that creates very loud noise. A noise abatement trim, such as Whisper 3 or Whisper Flow, should be used in the control valve. There will also be a diffuser or silencer downstream of the valve that discharges to atmosphere to further reduce the noise. The valve will need to be sized with consideration for the silencer, as the silencer will create back pressure for the valve outlet. While there is generally an isolation valve upstream of the control valve, it is important for the sky vent valves to shut off tightly in the event there are issues with the isolation valve. With the high steam temperatures, Class 5 shutoff using 800 pounds per inch of seat load and a bore seal is recommended. Additionally, since the differential pressure is relatively constant, a linear trim characteristic should be used.